That was a heck of an impact. Let me know you're okay.
Bad luck, Sadie. That must be incredibly disappointing. How will not making Q3 affect your strategy? Do you think your teammate was enjoying themselves in front of their home crowd? How do you feel this season is going for you? Is the car Appreciate your time.
Hello and welcome to the Circuit Paul Ricard, current home of the French Grand Prix, an event dating all the way back to 1906. It's been held at many venues over the years, with famous moments from Dijon and Manicourt the feature of many a highlights reel. And let's hope we see more of those in the race today. We have 15 corners here at the Circuit Paul Ricard, 6 to the left and 9 to the right. The rain is coming down and making for a slippery racing surface, but luckily there is plenty of runoff available, and hopefully we'll be able to avoid bringing out a safety car during today's Grand Prix. Alongside me to discuss all the action today is Anthony Davidson. Thanks for joining us, Ant. And tell me, you were down in the pit lane earlier. How do you think the track conditions are today?
Well, the surface looks clean enough, but I'm a little bit worried about the track temperature. It's pretty cool out there, which could give some teams difficulties when it comes to keeping their tyres in the right operating window. The cars out there that work their tyres hard and really put a lot of energy through them, they'll be the ones that are better off.
Before we begin, let's take a quick look at the grid lineup for today's race. A fantastic effort from Lance Stroll yesterday puts him on pole position, and Valtteri Bottas will line up alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Verstappen, Perez, Daniel Ricciardo, and Norris, Leclerc, Sainz, Vettel, and Pierre Gasly. Fernando Alonso, Ocon, Kimi Raikkonen, and Giovinazzi. Mick Schumacher, Mazepin, George Russell, and Nicholas Latifi. Hamilton, and more. That's it then, it's time to go racing as we head to trackside for today's race.
Okay, you need to give that position back. That was an illegal overtake. some information on Alonso. They have an issue with their car. They're going to be slow. The fastest lap at this point in time is a 1:41.2. Some information on Gasly. They have some kind of mechanical problem. A new strategy is available on the MFD. Copy. Approaching the pit window, you'll be on the softs. Okay, pick up rubber and bring it home.
A great race then, and a fantastic victory here at Paul Ricard. Anthony, tell me, what was it that helped them achieve this success?
Well, I honestly feel it was down to the driver and car today. I mean, we can talk driver skill all day, but if you don't have a solid team to back that, you're never going to get anywhere. When you hit that sweet spot of having both an excellent driver and an incredible car, that's when you see results like those we witnessed today.
Mercedes are on top form once again after an excellent race weekend. It's great to see them up on that podium once again. More points for Valtteri Bottas, further solidifying his lead at the top of the table. So, Anthony Davidson, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
I have to give it to Moore. Look at where they finished compared to where they started. It's not easy to cut through the field like that in Formula One, so it was a great effort.
It's time to check out the constructors' standings. No change in the top spot, but with today's points, their hold on the lead is getting weaker. Meanwhile, Ferrari have improved their position. A strong weekend from them as they fight their way towards the top. I'm equal parts exhausted and elated.
I know we were expecting some new developments to come through, but some of them have failed quality control. We'll need to tell the team what to redevelop via the R&D screen.